So if you compare this massive agrofuels expansion with the rice production in Asia, and I'll zero in the Philippines, we only have for the past 15 years allocated 4 million hectares for rice. And in Asia, rice is synonymous to food security. If we don't eat rice, we feel very insecure, and that's equivalent to going hungry in Asia. We eat it 3 times, even 5 times a day. Yet, we can only allocate 4 million for rice production, yet we can commit in the past 2 to 3 years 100,000 hectares for jatropha to Spain, 20,000 hectares to China, 1 million hectares to China for corn, rice, and sorghum for agrofuels, and 1.2 million hectares for jatropha, or a total of 2.3 million hectares of land for agrofuels. So this land could have been used or could be used for food production, yet we committed it for agrofuels. Or it could be under currently it could be under food production system, but we're committing it to agrofuels. And our consumption pattern is also increasing. We love rice so much that even the per capita consumption is increasing, no, through the years. It's not just population, but there's also an increased amount in consumption per individual. So the massive agrofuels plantation that's happening now in Asia compete for area and investments. So the resources that goes into it is channeled into, rather than food production, it goes into agrofuels. And with farmers, having had the privilege of working with farmers, there's no such thing as marginal lands. Farmers can actually work out and create very diverse food systems, even in marginal places.